Hello, welcome to my channel. I will show FreeCAD assembly tutorial in this video. I show assembly 2 plus and assembly 4 tutorials in my latest videos. If you want to watch them, you can look my videos. This time I will show assembly 3 tutorial in FreeCAD. Before start tutorial, I want to show how to set up assembly 3. Firstly, click Tools and click Add-on Manager. You will see all installed and uninstalled parts. I installed before, so I don't need to install again. You can see assembly tree here. Select assembly tree and you will click Install button. It's very easy to install. After complete install, you can start with Assembly Tree Manager or Assembly Tree Workbench. You will see here Assembly Tree. Now I can start Assembly Tree. I will use this technical drawing. I share link of this drawing. There will be three parts to draw. After drawing, I will assemble them. I will use assembly tree workbench. It will be easy drawing if I compare with other drawings. So I will start with part design. Click new file button. Click sketch button and I select XY plane. Now I can start drawing. Before start, I look technical drawing. Firstly, I will start with part 1. I draw square. Click rectangle button. Select a square randomly. Click this button and I select these three points. Firstly, I click this point and this point. Lastly, I click center point. Now I will draw circle parts. I draw two circle. Then I will use trim button. I don't need these parts. Also this part. Now I will enter. I enter dimensions. It will be 80 mm. Then I enter dimension for other sides. Again, it will be same, 80 mm. Now I enter circle dimensions. I select diameter, and it will be 24 mm. It's same for this side. Now I need to fix this point and this line. They must be coincident. So click this line and click this point by pressing Ctrl K from your keyboard and click fix button. Now it fix it. I will do same thing for right side. Again click this point and click this line, enter, fix button. Now it fix it. All lines are fixed. You can see all lines are green. Now I close this sketch. I select isometric view to see clearly. Click back button and it will be 15 mm. Click OK. Now I select this face and click sketch button. I will make a hole to the center. So I click circle and I click center point. It will be 20 mm. Click circle button, circle dimension button and I will enter 20 mm. Now click close to go 3D environment. I click pocket button. It will be 5 mm. Then this part is finished. Don't forget to save. Click save button. I will write part 1. You can write any name. And click save. Now I can start with second part. Click new file button. Click sketch button and select XY plane and click OK. Now we can start to draw second part. Click rectangle button. Draw a square randomly. Now click symmetry button. Click corner points. Lastly, click center point. Now it becomes symmetric. Now I start to draw circles. Click circle button. Click center point. Now I need to draw construction line. So I click construction mode button. Then click line. Click this point and this point. Now I close construction button. So click construction mode button again. Now click circle button. I will draw 2 circles. I draw randomly. Then I will enter dimensions. Now you can see it fix it, but I need to enter dimensions. So I look technical drawing. I will enter 8 mm. Now again, I select this line and I will enter 8 millimeters. This time I will add circle dimensions. So I click this button and select this circle. Enter 50 millimeter diameter and enter 20 millimeters diameter. Again, same for this circle, 20 millimeters. Now I need to fix these two lines. To do this, I select this point, press Ctrl K from your keyboard, then select this circle and click Fix Constraint button. I will do same things for this circle. Click this point and press Ctrl K, select this circle and click Fix button. Now it becomes green. All constraint and dimensions are added. Now I will trim these lines, so I click Trim button and I start to trim these lines. I will do same things for this side. Now I click Close button to go 3D environment. I select isometric view to see clearly. Now I click Path button. I will enter 50 millimeters length. Part 2 is completed. I will save this part. Click Save button. Write Part 2 for file name and click Save button. Now I can start with Part 3. Click New File button. Click Sketch button. Select XY plane and click OK. Click Circle button. Draw a circle which has 24 millimeter dimension. Diameter. Click Diameter and enter 20 millimeters. Click Close. Select isometric view. Click Path button. It will be 60 millimeter length. Then click Save button. I write Part 3. Now all parts are finished. After finish this drawing, I start with assembly tree. So I need to select assembly tree from workbench. I select assembly tree here and click new file. I write assembly tree for the name of file. You can write any name. Click assembly tree and click create an assembly button. Now I will start to import part 1, part 2 and part 3. So click link part. Before do that, I need to select all part. Click body, click assembly and click import button. Before do that, I need to save document. So I write assembly. Now I can start to import all parts. Select part 1, click body, again click assembly and click this button. I will do these same things for part 1, part 2 and part 3. Click body and click import button. Again select part 3 and click this button. Again I will select part 1, click body and click this button. Now I can start to add body. I will give a name. I write button. This is middle part. I write mid. This is cylindrical part. And this is the part, top part. Now I change all names. Now I select all part. Press Ctrl K from your keyboard, select all parts and I will move assembly, drag it and select assembly. Now all parts went to here. Now I will move because it can be confused. Click here. Click OK. And select this part. And click Move button. And I will move here. Select, click this face and I lock this part to fix it. Now I will start with cylindrical part. So I will move it to see clearly. Now I can start to constraint. Select this face and this face. Click axial button. Then select this face and this face. Click plane coincident button. After adding constraints, click solve constraints button. Now this part assembly is completed. I will continue with other parts. Select this face, press Ctrl K and select this face. And click plane alignment button. Then select this face and this face. Click coincident button. After adding constraints, I will click solve constraint button. Now this part is completed. Lastly, I will finish top part. So I need to change this part direction. So click here and click move button. I will rotate this part and click OK. If you want to rotate, you should use green line and click OK. Now select this face and this face. Don't forget to press Ctrl K. If you don't do that, it won't see two faces. Click plane alignment button. Select this face, press Ctrl K and select other face. Click plane coincident button. Lastly, click solve constraint button. Now assembly is finished. I want to see middle part, so I select middle and press Ctrl D K or right click and click appearance. I will select transparency to see middle part and to see our assembly clearly. You can change here. Click close. Now you can see clearly. Assembly 3 tutorial is finished. It was easy part. I will draw and other parts, it will be more complicated. This was the first tutorial of assembly tree. I will draw more parts. Lastly, I want to show how to hide parts. Select part. For example, I want to hide this part. Select top part and press spacebar from your keyboard. If you want to show again, select top and press spacebar again. Now it will come back. Assembly tree tutorial is finished. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and like the video.